I'm Cheryl Sleboda from SoMuchCosplay.com, and I am a lifelong fiber artist, quilter, and costumer. And one of the really hot trends in cosplay right now is armor building. And it's even something that's so popular that commercial patterns that you can buy are actually creating armor out of foam. And the foam that I'm using is not your typical craft foam. The foam I'm using is EVA foam. And the EVA foam comes in lots of different colors and thicknesses, and the thickness that I'm using for this project is a 2 millimeter thickness. What I do is I take my pattern for my shoulder piece that we're making, and the shoulder piece is called a pauldron. And what we're gonna do is cut out all of the pieces out of our craft foam, including all of these trim pieces. And then I'm going to use contact cement, and I'm going to glue them all together. Here is one that I've already glued together with all of the contact cement. And you can see here that this piece actually folds together, and you would glue that piece together with the contact cement so that you get this nice curve to the shoulder. Now the next thing you're gonna do is you're going to fill in any of the gaps that you have on your craft foam piece, and you're going to fill that in with just spackle that you get from the hardware store. So once you're ready to shape the piece a little bit, because you do want it to have some curve to your body, and I do that using a heat gun. And so what I'll just do is turn on my heat gun and form this very carefully, and be careful because this is hot. And then you'll want to create that curve so that your pieces, when they're all formed, they actually look like armor pieces. So the next thing you need to do is to paint your armor. And I have actually sanded down any of the spackle that was sticking up and actually went ahead and spray painted my pieces. And I also went back in and trimmed it out with a little bit of craft paint, just to give it a little more antique-y feel so that it looks more like armor. Next up, we need to create a strap for the actual armor piece. And to do that, I'm actually going to take a measuring tape, and I'm going to measure on your body, or using a friend to help you. You're going to just do this measurement straight to the shoulder, and you want to actually create your strap as long as the piece, all the way here to the end of the shoulder strap. So what you're gonna do is create this length as long as this. The reason for that is because you need some extra for the creation of the buckle, and also for the strap to actually go through the buckle. And that's why you want it to go all the way to the shoulder. So once you're ready, we're gonna go ahead and sew the strap. So you're gonna cut your strap 3 inches wide. The fabric that I'm using is this suede cloth. So it's cloth that actually is supposed to look like suede, but it is not suede. But it has the look of suede, and it sews really nice. And so that's what we're going to be using. Now what I've done with my piece is I have folded it in towards itself and then in half, and that creates the raw edges are all turned to the inside of the strap. And so I'm ready to sew here. And what I just do here, put this under my needle, and what I'm going to make sure I do is keep it about an eighth of an inch away from the folded edge. And so I'm going to just readjust this a little bit here and start sewing. Now I'm gonna take my pins out because I don't wanna sew over my pins. Now I'm not gonna sew all the way down the end of this strap, but you get the idea. You've got one side sewn like that, and now I'm going to cut these threads and just sew down the other side so you can see what that looks like. Okay. Now that I have both of these done, put my needle back up, you can see that I'm ready to. So I've sewn down both sides, and so all of this puffiness goes away when you create that second seam. Now I'm ready to sew on my buckle. Now my buckle has a center bar, and the center bar is what you're going to take the end of your newly sewn strap, and you're going to just fold that over the center bar, and you're going to leave yourself enough room to create a little back stitch. And so I'm just already have one pinned here, and so I'm just gonna show you that little tiny stitch and we'll be good to go. Get that under there. And once you get to the very end of the strap, you're just gonna hit the reverse button, and you're just gonna go back and forth a couple of times. And there you go. So now your buckle is sewn on, and you only wanna do that onto the one side of the strap. You don't need to do that on both. Okay, so now it is time to put your rivets in. Now to create your hole, there is your rivet kit that comes with an awl. And what you wanna do is take your awl and position that right over where you're going to create a hole. And you're gonna make pound on top of that so that you get your hole directly into your either your garment or onto your armor piece. So we are ready to set a rivet. Once you're ready to go, your rivet setting kit comes with two sections to it. The first one is the bottom. You can tell that it's a little bit concave. That is so that your rivet goes directly into that spot. The other portion that you're going to be pounding, you'll see that it has a concave section as well. Now, if I flip this over, you'll see this side does not have a concave, and that is so that when you're pounding, you wanna make sure that this side is not down on your rivet because you'll damage the rivet. This side that's concave, it's just gonna cradle the rivet directly and you'll be able to put this together nice and easy. So I've got my rivet in there. I set my fabric or my project on top. And you can actually snap these together. You'll be able to hear it snap. Now, the one thing is you can hear it rattling if it's not set. That's how I know that a rivet's not set. If it's rattling a little bit, you know you need to pound it a little more. So I'm gonna get that all set up. I'm going to get my concave section down directly on top. You wanna work on a sturdy surface, and you're gonna use your handy hammer, and we're ready to pound. And once you lift up your rivet, I don't hear any rattling, so you know that you are good to go. I can go ahead and set a bunch of rivets along the strap. And the reason I would wanna do that is that when I create my buckle, then I would actually have a place for my, my strap to catch on the buckle so that it doesn't come undone, which is a nice handy feature. Now I'm also gonna do the same riveting technique to the armor pieces. And what I would wanna do is make sure that I connect my armor here at the bottom and at the top of the next piece. And so I would create a hole with my awl and I would just pound a hole there and create a rivet that connects these two pieces together. So here we are over at the armor pieces. You can see that the rivets give you the ability to have an articulation in your armor piece, which is really nice. And also the rivets create sort of a decoration and also serve a purpose on the strap. So I hope you really enjoyed this armor project, and I hope you give this a try in your next cosplay.